In my work as a clinician, one of the things I've noticed is how people become very blindsided by this debate around legal and illegal drug use. And society is actually flooded with drugs. We have lots of drugs around us. We have coffee, we have tea, we have sugar. We have other medications that we can buy in supermarkets, Panadols and all sorts of different things. And people fail to see that these are actually quite deadly drugs in some instances. One of the keys to this, I think, is people being educated. People actually finding out information and being able to access information around the certain drug types and breaking away from those barriers that are provided by the legal and illegal viewpoint. And when we talk about education, another tool that then produces is the workstation. This is just a flat poster with lots and lots of different drug images on them and a QR reader, so that people actually access information on their phones. I've had a wonderful experience of having one of these outside my office window. I've seen how many times people will actually connect with that poster to get really accurate information on the various drug types. And we're not talking about what your class of standard drug users. I'm talking about families of people that will stand there and look at this stuff and actually talk about it. What a brilliant opportunity to self-learn. And self-learning is such an important tool, because what people absorb themselves usually sticks. What people get told can be dismissed very easily. A classic example, I think, is the story I tell about Bob, who's a builder. He uses stimulants, he uses nicotine, he uses coffee, he uses energy drinks during the day and during the afternoon, and then goes home and de-escalates himself with alcohol. And then in order to wake up in the morning, he takes a handful of Panadol. What is happening for Bob is there's some very serious health risks here, because Bob's also medicated because he has other injuries from his sports career, previous to his building career, and from his life as a builder. Bob is high risk of overdose. And these are legal drugs that he's taking. His prescription combinations and all the stimulants and the depressants that he's taking during the day are all very, very legal. When I challenged Bob about this, he got very upset with me when I said to him that he's actually chemically managing his life. But it was an opportunity to start to talk to Bob and to encourage him to start to learn and start to educate himself about what some of the ramifications may be from a health perspective about what he was doing to his body. So one of the learning opportunities from Bob's story is the fact that this is very normal behaviour for a lot of people, and people will know somebody that maybe even is doing the same sort of stuff as Bob. So it gives people the opportunity to actually start to bring up those health issues and encourage people to start to learn and try to change their behaviours. So I guess the important message for me in this is, just because it's legal doesn't mean it doesn't cause harm.